Alhamdulillah, we're in the beginning of a new Islamic year. And this is the month of Muharram, the very first month in the Islamic year. And this month is a very significant month that the Prophet ﷺ himself, when he first came to this beautiful city, this exact city of Medina al-Munawwara, when he came here, he found some of the people that had already lived here, which were the Jewish people. They were fasting in this month, a particular day, the 10th day of this month. And on this day, when he saw them fasting, he was already fasting this day in Mecca, but he was surprised to find the Jewish people fasting. So he asked them, why do you fast on this day? And they said that on this day we fast in remembrance and thankfulness to God, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because on this day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Musa from Fir'aun, saved Moses from Pharaoh. And this is why we fast, and this is why we show thankfulness. Because in this day, in this month, is when a great prophet was saved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from oppression and tyranny of a great oppressor, Pharaoh. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ, when he saw that, he was actually impressed. But he said something very powerful about it. He said, نَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِمُوسَى مِنْكُمْ. He said, we have more right to Moses. He's a prophet. And he came with the same message. And he said that we have more right to Moses than you do. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ commanded an obligationary command, not just even voluntary, commanded the believers to fast on the 10th day of this month. And when it was a commandment at that time, this was the very first action, one of the very first acts that happened in terms of legislation in Medina, because the Prophet ﷺ had just come here. So the fasting of Ashura in the 10th day of this month was an obligation on the Ummah. This was before the obligation of Ramadan. The following year after that, is when Ramadan became obligatory. But they fasted this month as an obligation. The Prophet ﷺ said, the hadith that's narrated by Imam Muslim, said, أَفْضَلُ الصِّيَامِ بَعْدَ رَمَضَانِ شَهْرُ اللَّهِ مُحَرَّمُ. He said that the best fasting after the month of Ramadan is the month of Allah, the month of God, Muharram. The Prophet ﷺ, as we mentioned, when he came and he commanded the believers to fast in the month of Muharram, he said that this is the best month to fast after Ramadan. After Ramadan. Ramadan is an obligation. And when Ramadan became an obligation, this month became a recommended thing for us to fast as much as we can. And this is because it is a holy month, it is a sacred month. It is from the four sacred months in the Islamic calendar. So, what is the sacred month? What are we talking about? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has specified certain months, and He has specified certain days, and He has blessed certain times and places. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran in Surah At-Tawbah. Inna iddat ash-shuhuri 'inda Allah 12 shahra fi kitabillah yawma khalaqa as-samawati wal-ard minha arba'atun hurum dhalika ad-dinul qayyim fala tadhlimu fihinna anfusakum. He said that the number of months with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has set are 12 months, which He has ordained on the day when He created the heavens and the earth. And they are four of these months that are sacred months, that are Ashhur Hurum. And these months, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that is the right religion. So in these particular 4 months, make sure that you don't wrong yourself in it. Make sure that you don't sin in these 4 months. Make sure that you don't commit oppression in these four particular months. These 4 months, there are three, one after the other. And they are the 10th month, called Dhul Qi'dah, the 11th month called Dhul Hijjah, which is the 2 months where the Hajjaj come to do Hajj. These are holy months, sacred months. And the third month, which is the very first month right after that, called Muharram, which we are in right now. And then Rajab, which is after this. And some people might ask, why is Ramadan a sacred month? Well, Ramadan is a sanctified, a month which there's a level of holiness, a level of sacred that we uphold, but it is not considered one of the four sacred months. So we have to differentiate between the four sacred months and also other months which have virtue. And obviously Ramadan is the most virtuous of months because the Quran was revealed, but interestingly enough, it was not called one of the four Ashhur al-Hurum, one of the four sacred months. So Muharram is one of these sacred months. What is one of the things that we need to consider when this month takes place? The very first and foremost thing is Allah said in this ayah, do not commit wrong in it against yourselves. In this month, try not to sin. Because sinning in this month is actually much worse than if you were to sin in another month. And that's why it's so important. A lot of people don't know this. In Muharram, it is actually called Muharram because it was considered haram, sacred. It was considered sacred even before Islam. This is a month where the Quraysh used to stop fighting amongst one another and used to stop any kind of evil toward each other because of the sanctity of this month. So that's why they started to call it Muharram. So this is why one of the first things we need to consider, make sure that you withhold yourself even more so in other times in this particular month from doing any sins and any kind of evil, and try to withhold and make sure you control your self from doing so. So the Prophet ﷺ, like we said, used to say that this is the best month to fast in after Ramadan. So this is something that we need to consider. Number two of the significance and virtues of this month is try to increase in your fast, not just in a particular day in Ashura and the day before, but rather also the rest of the month as well. If you have fast to make up from Ramadan, if you have fast to make up because of doing nadr or making an oath, etc., or you just want to do voluntary fast, try to do as much voluntary fast as you can, because this is the greatest month that you need to fast in. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in the hadith by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu wa'ta, who said that ما رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صام يوما يتحرى فضله على الأيام إلا هذا اليوم يعني عاشوراء. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, in this hadith, Ibn Abbas said, I never saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم care more or be cautious more than fasting a particular day than the 10th day of this month. And that day is called Ashura. So particularly on this day, the Prophet ﷺ used to be extremely cautious to make sure he fasts this day, and commanded and recommended for the companions to fast it on the 10th day of this month, just like the rest of the month is voluntary. The 10th day is even more recommended. Why? The Prophet ﷺ, like we said, was told by the Jewish people that on this day, Musa alayhi salam was saved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the oppression of Pharaoh. But also, the virtue that is specific to fasting on this day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, I hope that Allah will forgive your sins for the previous year. Subhanallah. Your sins are all forgiven for the previous year if you fast this one day in commemoration of this gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is among the virtues of this month. And this is why Ashura is such a big deal. This is in fact the biggest deal of Ashura, is that we fast on this day, because the Prophet ﷺ said, if you fast on this day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins of the previous year, the year that just passed. SubhanAllah, that's amazing. And one of the amazing things is Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah, and our own Shaykh, the Shaykh of Medina, Shaykh Muhammad Muqtar al-Shaykh rahimahullah, Allah preserve, he said that I view the view of some of the great scholars of this ummah, like Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah and others, who said that the major and minor sins will be forgiven if you fast on this day. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, I hope that your sins will be forgiven. He left it open, and he didn't say only the major or only the minor sins. He said all of your sins. If you're sincere and you're doing it for the sake of Allah, you fast on Ashura, Allah will forgive your major and minor sins. And there's differences between among this, but this is the view that we hold and the view of many great scholars in this ummah, because the Prophet ﷺ mentioned it openly, all of your sins. And one of the things that we need to understand of why this month is so great, and one of the reasons that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned to us that on this, in this month is when all of the prophets used to fast. He said, وَهَذَا كَانَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ يَسُومُونَهُ وَكَذَلِكَ قُرَيْشُ فِي الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. He said that the people of the previous generations used to fast this, and also the Quraysh used to fast it. And he said in the hadith, يَوْمْ عَاشُرَى كَانَ تَصُومُهُ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ فَصُومُوهُ أَنْتُمْ. And this hadith is authentic. He said that on Ashura, this 10th day, the prophets, all of them used to fast on this day, so you all fast as well. So this is the tradition of not just the Prophet ﷺ and not just the Jewish people, but also all of the prophets and messengers. To the extent that one of the scholars, Imam al-Qurtubi, said that even the pagans in Quraysh used to fast this day because of the tradition of Ibrahim, Abraham, who built the Kaaba. they wanted to preserve this tradition, so that's why they continued the fast as well. So this is a tradition of all of the prophets, as the Prophet mentioned, that this is on the 10th of Ashura, a day when all of the prophets used to fast, so you all fast as well.